There may have been two parts to that question. I'm not sure, but I'm going to answer a question that maybe you didn't answer. You ask first,
okay?
Which is, as a student, because I had an internship, like you said, I had a vague understanding of whether something was going to be useful or not in my career, but by no means did I know that at all. In fact, I distinctly remember not wanting to pay attention and do well in thermodynamics because I didn't care about it. And I was like, I'm not going to work. I'm not going to do thermodynamics. I'm not going to do heat transfer. I don't really care. I want to do controls and I want to do dynamics and all of that. And then it wasn't until later that I got to, you know, industry, and it's like, oh, controls touches everything. Sometimes you're trying to control temperature and thermodynamics and heat transfer and all of that stuff that I didn't really care about and didn't pay attention to and didn't want to learn because I thought it wasn't going to be beneficial to me. Turns out I was wrong. And I guess that would be my advice back to myself, which is, even if you're learning the Ralph Hurwitz criterion and you know it's not going to be useful, you don't actually know. And so treat everything as though it's going to become useful. Try to absorb as much information as you can through, you know, while you're learning, because you never know where that's going to be applied in your career. And for me, I've always gravitated to jobs that I could learn at, but also could be valuable in. And you're valuable when, and that I'm excited about. And I wouldn't know all of that stuff if I hadn't, you know, like I don't know how to say this, I guess, but I could have migrated into a thermo, like engineering position if I'd paid more attention to it. And who knows, I may have loved it. And I've missed out on the greatest opportunity of my life because I didn't have that knowledge and I didn't gravitate over to it because I thought, oh, that's not for me. And I think I ended up in controls because I had a little bit of interest in it. And I always just sort of sought out those jobs and built my sort of repertoire and experience up that way.
So how, at what point, because specifically you mentioned that like you were super into controls. So at what point did you kind of realize, was it kind of in the high school age when you were doing like math and physics and chemistry, or was it more when you started getting into undergrad that specifically, oh, I really like controls?
Absolutely undergrad. It wasn't until my first internship at Boeing. Mm. In fact, it was between my sophomore and junior year. I sort of embarrassingly had never really heard of controls still at that point. And I interviewed for my internship, and there's a whole like class of interns that come into Boeing. And then there's a person who sort of farms them out to the various groups that just were like, oh, we'll take an intern. And in this sort of post interview where they're just trying to figure out where everybody should go, I was asked what my favorite class was. And at the time it was differential equations, which was just amazing because it just felt like my first applied mathematics course. That might not even be true, but that's how I felt about it. It was like, oh, all of this sort of abstract math with differential equations, it applies to real physical systems, which is just crazy. And I think that is what caused this person to place me in a line of sight and controls group, was that answer. And luckily when I got to that group, it was just filled with some really amazing people and people who really wanted to teach and mentor and explain everything. And I left that 9-month co-op or internship with a love of controls. And I went into it with honestly thinking that it was like controlling a spacecraft from the ground, like ground operations. Oh, it's control. So we're going to be the ones sending the commands, you know, to the vehicle. That's what I thought I was getting myself into. And then I left understanding it a lot better and wanting to then pursue that as my career.
So then when you got back to school after your internship, because the experience that I had with controls in school is that it was just like, whoa, this math is way different. Like, this is not the kind of math that I'm used to seeing. And it's really interesting. So I guess in the internship, was your interest sparked kind of from the math sense of it or what you could do from it, or kind of like where was kind of, yeah, what really grabbed your attention there?
this is where I was saying, like, I could have become a thermodynamicist. It's really, it was the whole experience of the co-op. It wasn't the math. It wasn't the fact that I could, you know, do robotics or, you know, remotely operate vehicles or anything like that. It was just, it was such a good overall experience from the team that I was working with, the fact that I learned a bunch, and I think I could have done that anywhere, honestly. So I feel like I lucked into it. And then when I left, I didn't really understand the math all that well after co-op, because, you know, they don't really focus on mathematics. They focus on getting the job done or whatever. It's like, oh, you know, we need to build up this model and verify it, make sure that it's okay, because we're going to use it to tune our games or something, right? Mm-hmm. I left, I was like, oh, I got to do this. So I took my first controls class, and it was classical controls, you know, frequency domain, Laplace transforms and transfer functions and stuff. And we've done everything in state space, and I had no idea what any of this stuff was. and it was the same thing where it's just like, wow, what are we learning? This is crazy. Yeah. And so, yeah, I don't think I have a very good story about how I got into controls. I really lucked into it. I didn't understand what it was when I fell in love with it. And that just sort of drive stayed with me to, like, relearn all of this stuff that I sort of skipped past and play catch up, I guess. Let me answer a question here anyway, is that I didn't know what I wanted to do before I went into my first internship. So anything was okay with me. After that, I knew what I wanted to do. And so I sought out very specific things. And so I think that's the difference, is that if you don't know what you want, or if you don't know if the thing that you want to do is really the thing that you want to do, because you don't know enough of out there to make that choice, right? To, like, sort of go down that path. Broadening your experience is a good idea. And I sort of advocate for that anyway, even if you think you know what you want to do, especially as internships, right? Bounce around each internship and do something vastly different. Don't go back to the same company every time. Don't go back to the same group every time. Because if you did a good enough job and they liked you, they'll take you back even 2 years later if you wanted to do an internship somewhere else the next year or something like that. So that's what I would recommend. And I'd recommend that again to myself, because who knows, maybe I missed out on some great opportunity early on because I was like, this is what I want to do. And I stuck with it. But you can do both things, right? You can keep your, you know, expose yourself to as many things as possible. Once you start narrowing in on the things that you know you like, the things you know you're good at, the things you know you want to continue doing for the rest of your career, you can slowly start switching from an opportunistic, I'm just going to take whatever comes my way and see what happens, into more of, you know, exploiting very specific opportunities and seeking them out and letting it known that that's where you want to go and that's what you want to do, and turning down the rest.
So as far as, so you did the internship, then you went back to school. Was it a pretty easy decision to go back to Boeing full time when you graduated, or did you consider some other companies as well, or how did that go?
No, super easy. Mostly because if you agreed to come back after you graduated and you signed on as an employee, essentially before you went back to your last year of school, mm-hmm. Boeing would pay your last year of school.
Oh, wow.
And so that was super easy. And then you had to, like, commit to 2 years or something with them afterwards. But it's like, oh, they're going to pay my fully the last year of my college if I just come in, and then they're going to give me a job for 2 years. Yes, yeah. Please. And so
that's easy.
Yeah. So it was quite easy.
So I guess, so then did you not feel very much pressure, I guess, towards the end of going through your school, kind of like, oh, I kind of have a job line.
Zero pressure. It was the worst. Like the worst bout of senioritis ever. It was just like, I already have a job. I don't have to interview. I don't really care. it was a struggle. Like, certain classes obviously are fun and, you know, interesting no matter what. But the ones that you, like, like the thermodynamics of my senior year, whatever that was brutal. It was it was so hard to get through.
So how was I guess so you went to Embry-Riddle, and that's in Arizona if I remember correctly.
There is one in Arizona, but I went to Florida.
Oh yeah. Oh, okay. I think I've been to the one in Arizona. Okay, yeah, right. The main one's in Florida, right? That's the main campus.
Yeah, Daytona Beach.
So how was kind of just moving across the country then, going to California? Well, I guess you'd already been there for a little bit, but how was that whole experience?
Yeah, I was fine. I mean, I grew up in New Mexico. I almost went to the Arizona one. So I had been sort of bouncing around for a while there. And the way Boeing did their internship, at least back then, I don't know if they still do it this way. It was pretty awesome because they would hire an entire class of, I don't know, 20 of us. And then they would put us all up in the exact same corporate housing complex for 9 months. You know, a bunch of college students that for the very first time in our lives earned a decent paycheck and didn't have homework. And that first internship, I'm still really good friends with several of those people. I mean, like we just took to each other because you're just spending 24/7 with each other and doing everything that California has to offer, you know, skiing and surfing and just hitting the beach and doing all that kind of stuff, that it was, you know, that's kind of what, you know, made it a non-issue to sort of move across the country, because it's like a bunch of my really good friends now did the exact same thing. They're like, oh yeah, we're all going to take this job. They're going to pay for our last year of school. We're all coming out. And we all came back, and, you know, the majority of us got jobs with them, and we all came back after our college, you know, senior year, and it went right back into just, you know, not having to adapt to a new situation. It was just coming back to old friends.